Good day, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, I'm here to give you a performance with my friend Chandrajit. He's one of the leading tabla in South India. He's a student of Pandit Abhijit Banerjee, and he has performed for all the music directors in Tamil, and is an upcoming album composer as well. So put your hands together for Chandrajit. And I'm also here to present a concept which the musicians of today, of the contemporary musicians, should be familiar with. It's called fusion. Fusion is something that evolved in the late 60s, I would say, because whenever new sound comes into the picture, the musicians of the previous generation would want to express themselves using the new sound. So that is how the fusion music came into the picture. And I have been fortunate enough to have played with many leading Carnatic musicians and Hindustani musicians in the country, and to have accompanied them for their fusion concerts. So I feel very privileged and honored to have accompanied many leading artists in that regard. Now, I'm here to give you a presentation and a performance, of course, on a topic which is quite not so commonly seen in today's fusion music. I have called it adaptive classical fusion. It's what you see in the slide here. And I'm going to give you two performances today, and they are my compositions in this particular genre called adaptive classical fusion. Let me just run you through a few slides, just for a couple of minutes, to give you an idea as to what I'm going to talk about. This is it, adaptive classical fusion. Can I have the next slide? Okay, now let us just get to understand what fusion music is all about in the first place. You can broadly define fusion music as a type of music which is formed by combining two or more music genres to form a new genre. Like, for example, rock and roll. You must be familiar with Elvis Presley and all this Rolling Stones and all those popular bands of the early 70s. They used to perform rock and roll music. Rock and roll was formed from blues music, which was there in the 30s and 40s, country music and gospel music. Similarly, jazz fusion came into the vogue in the late 60s. It was formed from jazz, and it was after the popularity of funk music and R&B, which are basically sound based music, that jazz musicians wanted to perform using the sound of funk and R&B. That is how jazz fusion came into the picture. So what is clear from this concept of fusion is that it is all about incorporating new sound into existing music as and when instrument and sound technology develops. Now, have Indian musicians been an exception to this rule? Not really, because even in Indian classical music, namely Carnatic and Hindustani music, we have incorporated a lot of instruments of Western origin, namely violin, mandolin, saxophone and the synthesizer, which is also called the keyboard popularly. So we have had pioneers in the field of, we have had great maestros, Carnatic violinists, mandolin players, saxophone players, and also keyboard players who have mastered the art of performing Carnatic music on the keyboard, on the violin, the mandolin, and the saxophone. So fusion is not exactly alien to Indian classical music as well. But playing a Carnatic raga in a Western classical way, the pop music and R&B music became very popular in the 90s in India. So basically that led to even Indian classical musicians using drums and keyboard for their accompaniment in their concerts. That is how the current contemporary fusion came into vogue, which is basically, R&B, pop, sound based genres in combination with Hindustani and Carnatic music. Can I have the next slide, please? All right. Now, what is adaptive classical fusion that I have been talking about in the first place? Let us get to the adaptation part of the adaptive classical fusion. Basically, I am calling it adaptive because we are adapting a music that doesn't exactly fit into another kind of music. And I am calling it classical because we are talking about two different forms of classical music. What are they? Indian classical music and Western classical music. in the other genres that we have discussed till now, jazz fusion and all these things, jazz could fit into funk because they all came from the same source. But this is not the case here. Western classical music came from some other place, and Indian classical music has totally different roots. So that is why we need to adapt the two kinds of music to make them fuse correctly. And you should have seen on profile page that I received a title called Sangeetha Bhaskara in 2003 for performing Carnatic music on the keyboard. I used to perform that way back, that was about 8 years ago. So that was in 2003, this is 2011. How different have I become? I should have become different over the years, right? So what I thought was, I would get back to the original keyboard style of play, which is Western classical. Western classical was what the piano was meant to play for. Piano is not an instrument that has the wheels and tone combinations which you can exploit to play Carnatic music. It is a raw acoustic instrument. So in order to be able to accommodate Carnatic music on a piano, it is not easily adaptable to a piano. So what you need to do is, what I thought I could do is, I would just take the essence of classical Indian classical music and play the keyboard in a Western classical way. And there is a fundamental difference between these two classical art forms, which is called manodharma. In Indian classical music, we have a concept called manodharma, which basically refers to improvisation. In plain English, it simply means improvisation. Western classical music has boundaries. It has a lot of boundaries, but it has its own greatness, of course. But all the compositions in Western classical music are fixed. There is no way a performer can, you know, meddle with the piece, or there is no place for a performer to express his creativity in the piece. He can, of course, express his performance skills, but there is no room for his creativity to come out. Whereas for Indian classical music, the key differentiating factor between the good performer and great performer is this concept called manodharma, which is creativity. So, I have come here to present you a concept which is actually in its infancy stages only, it's not yet fully developed. So I'm going to demonstrate to you playing Western classical style on the keyboard. I'll be using a keyboard for convenience, but I'll be using only a piano patch, and I'll not be using the wheels and sliders which a keyboard can use to play Carnatic. And I'll be playing pure Western classical style today, but I'll be playing with the mindset of a Carnatic musician, which means I'm going to improvise, I'm going to do some stuff which is of creative nature. And the structure of my performances is going to be Indian classical. So that is about the performance I am going to give you today. It is something like playing a Carnatic raga in a Western classical way, but communicating the essence of the raga through a non-Carnatic means. That is exactly what I am going to do now. Can I have the next slide? Next slide, please. Alright. We'll move on to the performances now. Basically, I am going to play two pieces today. And the first piece, I call it Everything Within. This is based on Carnatic ragam called Sindhu Bhairavi, and this comes under a Carnatic structure called Ragam Thanam Pallavi. And the second piece is going to be Tarana Unlimited, which is not Carnatic, it's Hindustani fused with Western classical music. And yeah, we'll move on to the performance.
Thank you.
Okay, for the final performance. Tabla. Thank you.